10 days faculty development program by the Savitrabai Phule University is a very good initiative indeed. And at the outset, I must congratulate Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor N.R. Karmalkar sir, Honorable Director HRDC Professor Sanjeev Sonone, Principal of KTHM College Nashik Dr. V.P. Gaikwad, Coordinator of this 10 days faculty development program Dr. Vasant Boraste, all participants and friends. This is the very crucial time during COVID period, and it is very nice initiative which signifies the study and impact of COVID-19 on the economic development. And I am here to explain about the scenario of the real estate post-COVID. Friends, before COVID also there was a little bit of weakness in this sector, especially because of five things like demonetization, RERA, GST and NBFC crisis because of IL&FS, and global impact on overall economy because of global crisis such as Cold War between USA and China. In this respect, I want to explain about the various aspects like demonetization. It has given shock to this industry because there was some economy which was depend upon the pre-demonetization transactions, and because of shocking demonetization declaration, it has really impacted this industry. RERA, actually it is a good act, but sudden changes in the style of working in real estate where cash flow management was crucial to do post RERA has affected real estate on a large scale, and many new launches has reduced drastically. So RERA has affected real estate in a quite a large way. There was again declaration of GST. Because of GST, there was some confusion among the investors, among the end users, and that affected in investment in real estate, and they have delayed the decision in making real estate decisions. After RERA, then it comes NBFC fiasco. In this, lot of public sector banks have invested in NBFCs like IL&FS, and because of this many have taken trust factor into account about where to invest in NBFC or not, and there is a very large investment of NBFCs in real estate. This has turned into debt crisis and impact on the investment of NBFCs in real estate. So that has also weakened the real estate in this sector. This way, five factors have already weakened this real estate in this weakened the investment in real estate pre-COVID era. And there was also global impact on economy, like Europe was their GDP was quite getting reduced. Even USA and China, because of their Cold War, there is a hamper in manufacturing sector in India as well as globally, and that affected the investment in real estate because employment generation and the per capita income got affected pre-COVID era. So that was the position, and already real estate sector has taken a lot of shocks and got weakened pre-COVID era. Post-COVID era, or during the COVID, now you can't say it is a post, it is the during COVID, there was a survival mode, real estate was in survival mode. in survival mode, employment generation and the existing employment, there was uncertainty in this overall employment sector, and per capita purchasing power got reduced drastically. And without having extra money and purchasing power, real estate cannot sustain. So there is a concern about the getting surety to the employment is the main issue which may affect real estate in long term because of the effect of the COVID. So during this period, government has given some stimulus. There were some stimulus which were fiscal in nature, some stimulus was non-fiscal in nature, but there is a lot of deficit. These both the stimulus, fiscal and non-fiscal stimulus given by the central government, has not created any good effect from supply side as well as the demand side. There is a necessity to create some strong supply side and demand side to create some strongness in this sector, but because of stimulus there was a lot of deficit in stimulus as per requirement and the supply stimulus declared by the government. There is some deficit, and because of this deficit, real estate has not got the required boost. Same time, there was expectation of stimulus from state level because land is being the subject of state level. There was some requirement from state level, but many states have not yet given required stimulus in the form of stamp duty or reducing ready reckoner rate. Central level support system was necessary in the form of taxation like GST, income tax and taxes regarding the benefit to the supplier and contractors. So all stakeholders are required some stimulus from the central government, which is just it is still awaited, and no stimulus has been given directly in the form of fiscal or non-fiscal form. Secondly, there was moratorium declared from the central government, but the instead of RBI insisting it to banks, public sector banks, it has not reached up to the consumer. Consumer having construction finance or consumer having home loans, both are deprived of this both stimulus declared by the RBI government in the form of moratorium. So in totality, in survival mode, there was also some issues which were not yet addressed by both the government, and to make survival happen, it is very necessary. Migratory labors is also one of the problem which is affected unprecedentedly this time. Many labors have migrated, labor have done reverse migration. They have gone to their own homes because of insecurity and uncertainty in metros and many tier 2, tier 3 cities. There is a challenge of bringing them back, and without that, this industry is not going to cope up in near future. Cartelization of cement, that is also a very big issue. Many cement companies, they have become opportunist and they have increased the rate by 20 to 30%, and which is going to cost more in construction cost. That is one issue that is to be addressed for the controlling the construction cost and overall cost of the purchase of the end customer. Because of the many restrictions on the transportation, because of lockdown, and many storage spaces are already blocked because of lockdown, logistic issues has come up on a large scale, and supply management issues has also affected the overall construction of this industry, and that is also need to be addressed because of also that it has got affected. Regulatory and approval issues. In this total period, only 10% government staff has attended the offices, and because of that, many regulatory and approval issues has got stuck. Thousands and lakhs of approval all over India has got stuck because of this, and this will also affect the new launches and new construction may not be start during the nearby period. So that is also one issue that is pinching this industry during the survival mode. So before going for revival mode post COVID, we need to address all these issues which were pre-COVID issues and during the survival code issues. Central government, state government and all stakeholders have symbiotic responsibility and action to make this industry capable of doing new launch and getting new strength post-COVID issue. When we talk about post-COVID, it is very important to know about the existing constructed flats. We call it as existing inventory, and the flats or the units which are under construction, we call it as a to be completed inventory. And the third type of inventory, we can call it as a new launches inventory. Considering all these inventories, existing inventories, it is the costing in multi-billion dollar. And if there are no consumers to this inventory, there is going to be big deficit in real estate investment. And in turn, it is going to cost lot to economics. So it is responsibility of the government as well as all stakeholders to see that this inventory is not in steady position. It should move inventory, it should move all what is ready, what is under construction and what is in new launch has to move the economy and move GDP of our country. Secondly, because of uncertainty in visa regime of European countries as well as USA, there is very good scope for NRIs to invest in real estate in India. That is also to be tapped as far as post-COVID scenario is concerned. And government must give some incentives to the NRI investment in Indian economy, especially in real estate, which will make our economy boost in the form of real estate. So that NRI market, tapping of NRI market is the prime responsibility of all the stakeholders and the government in near future. As far as metro cities are concerned, tier 1 cities are concerned, tier 2 cities are concerned and tier 3 cities are concerned, their issues are very different. Their issues are peculiar. As far as metro cities are concerned, there are lot of large scale of slums and their problems are different, their approval problems are different, their investment in real estate construction cost is different and their consumer psychology is different. Tier 1, Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities, their unit sizes are also different, their investment size is also different and their approval problems are also different. In these areas, cost of development charges, cost of premium charges, cost of sales charges and cost of other statutory charges are very peculiar in this nature. So government should give some installment to these cities as per their requirement to make them affordable so that people will try to approve the new projects and try to launch new projects. For this demand of the real estate is not to curtail the charges, but give some installment and some moratorium so that people will tend to launch and people will tend to construct new projects in these all these areas. There is still very good scope in small cities for migration from village or we can say rural area to this tier 2, tier 1 and tier 3 cities, because there is still good affordability of this project. Costs are at very affordable level. So government should encourage migration from rural area to this area to buy the houses. That is one peculiar thing which should happen post COVID era. There are some policies which are very contradictory in the nature. Like there are rules like 43CA and 150C which don't allow people to buy below ready reckoner rate, and state government is not ready to reduce the ready reckoner rate. See, developers and real estate fraternity is ready to pay at lower rate at some point of time because of management of cash flow, but because of these contradictory sections or legal issues, they are not ready to sell even if they tend to sell, because if we sell at a lesser rate than the ready reckoner rate or stamp duty rate, they have to pay taxes to the central government under the section of 43CA or 50C. So these are the contradictory policies which should be removed to encourage the investment in real estate sector. As far as real estate sector is concerned, there are varieties of asset class. There are logistic asset class called, we called it as a storage areas. There is tourism related asset class, we called it as a hospitality. There is a education related, there is a entertainment related, there is a medical related, there is a commercial related, there is housing related. So all these asset class have got their own potential. Government should see that each asset class should flourish to encourage economy to grow. As far as the storage class is concerned, it will do very nice because of e-commerce. Storage place has got very good opportunity in near future. As far as entertainment, retail is concerned, because of lockdown it has got affected. So government should see that some incentives have been given to these classes so that they can flourish post COVID era. Hospitality, because of tourism fiasco during COVID, it has got affected. They should give some support to these sectors so that they can do better in near future. Contribution of real estate in economy is undoubtful. There are 250 industries which are dependent on real estate, and real estate is the second largest employer, and as far as GDP's participants are concerned, it is second largest employer, and government should see that employment generation as well as the industry dependent on real estate must survive post COVID so that economy will boost and its contribution to the GDP will sustain. Government had decided to do the housing for all concept by 2022 and have made many good decisions about the affordable housing. But implementation of these policies and decision is very crucial, and for that in metros like slum rehabilitation and in non-metros housing for all, by doing in joint venture with government is essential. There are many government employees which don't have houses, like police department, like PWD department, other departments of the government, which these employees doesn't have houses. If government come together and do some public-private partnership with the stakeholders and provide housing under the housing for all concept, it is very good opportunity for the government as well as stakeholders to create good consumable housing stock in near future. And policies are there, but implementation of policy should be done in effective way to make this industry grow in a large scale. Real estate always give multiplier effect in economy, because once real estate gets boost, overall economy gets boost. There are examples in China and other Latin American countries. They have boosted real estate for the growth of economy, and it has given multiplier effect to other industry and overall economy. So study group to consider that part of the multiplier effect is must by the government, and should see that this industry, how this industry give multiplier effect to Indian other industries, is of prime importance. Office spaces has done very good contribution in last few years in real estate sector. Many IT industries have taken a lot of office spaces in these past few years, and it has given boost to that asset class of industry. And I think post COVID era, this office industry, because of this distances, what we say, safe distances between the workers, it has created some doubt among the office asset class. There are two types of thinking. Some people say because of the safe distancing, there will be more requirement per square foot of the office space, per person per square foot of the office space. And there is the thought that people will start working from home, or flexible working will come up, and in that case there will be less demand for the offices. But I don't think there will be any home work from home culture will start in near future. So offices area may increase in near future, and once this offices area increase in multiple factor, it will necessarily give good effect to real estate. Inclusion of digital technology, PropTech, MediTech, and gig economy and women's empowerment will definitely give good effect. If government consider gig economy as a main booster in near future, it will really do the miracle, because of uncertainty of the employer, they will depend more upon gig economy in near future. And in a country like India, if government gives some organizational status to gig economy, it will have very good effect on our economy. MediTech has also have very good scope in near future, like wellness centers. Because of this COVID, people have got the conscious about the health, and wellness center and MediTech development will take very good shape in near future. There is one very important thing: women's empowerment and women's involvement in employment. Because many well-educated women in India, they still remain in the house and they don't do work, because there is no scope for working from home, and because of that many good talent is getting wasted in the form of educated women in India. So it is necessary for Indian government to make some policy where gig economy and women's empowerment and women's involvement in economy will get boosted, so that this will again support our economy. There is a very good urbanization is going on in India, and nearly 40 to 50% population will be migrating to urban areas in near future. And with this urbanization, dense population and neighborhoods are going to come up within some near future, within some years. And this public health is the main concern, and without taking good steps in all types of public health patterns, it is not going to sustainable healthy cities in near future. So making investment in public health and in turn supporting economy will also have a very good prospect in near future. There are lack of all types of public health facilities like primary, secondary and tertiary and high tech public health facilities. Because of these COVID issues, as also we are not able to control this COVID issue in this COVID area, but after COVID is over, post COVID, government should invest in public health and creating globally acceptable neighborhoods to counter next pandemic if it occurs in near future. There is also one peculiar thing has happened in real estate. There was to be seller's market 5 years back and 6 years back. There is to be seller's market. Now it is going to be buyer's market, and consumer is very peculiar in selecting the developers as well as the selecting the debt finance, and the interest rate is going to be key factor in investment in real estate. So government, public sector banks and all NBFCs should adhere to the direction given by RBI so that this investment in real estate becomes investment friendly because of interest rate for the purchasing of the houses and other real estate class. So to support these buyer markets, government's directive should be followed by the public sector banks and NBFCs. Considering all these effect and good prospect of the real estate, liquidity is going to play very big role, and government should think of foreign direct investment, easing the foreign direct investment for inventory which is already ready or which is in the verge of completion of the project. So FDI has to be changed so that there is liquidity flow in real estate in near future. Considering all the aspect what I have discussed, if government take some bold steps and some innovative steps, I don't think there is any problem in real estate. If government takes some optimistic and positive steps, this is going to boost in multiple way, and this will definitely boost Indian economy, considering the share of the economy of real estate, share of the real estate in overall economy. Thank you.